English. The secretly recorded conversations make it clear why so few of the generals were prepared to oppose Hitler.
Sie sagen es ja selber, wir haben Hitler den Aufstieg zu verdanken. Hitler hat uns unsere Jobs sozusagen gegeben. Wir können uns jetzt nicht gegen ihn stellen. Also das war sicherlich eine ganz besondere Bedeutung, dass diese Leute lange ja nicht befördert wurden, während der Reichswehrzeit, in der Weimarer Zeit, und nun mit Hitler ihre großen Karrieren begonnen haben. Die beginnen ja in der Mitte der 30er Jahre. Dann kommen die Leute zu ihren Generalstiteln, in die Generalsränge. Das prägt sie und das macht sie auch dankbar, das macht sie auch loyal.
The Nazi state has purchased their loyalty. Trent Park, near London. All the German generals captured in the West are held here. The building is luxuriously appointed, and every centimeter is monitored by hidden microphones. A rear admiral and a colonel can speak freely here. They're high-ranking officers, but they don't see themselves as responsible for anything.
That's what I mean. That's just what the senior Wehrmacht officers failed to say with one voice. We refuse to take part in these atrocities. They are a disgrace to the name of Germany.
The few that did didn't fare too well.
But if they had all just done so at the right time, for historians, it will be one of the great puzzles of world history, the fact that something like this was actually possible.
This is a historic guilt of the German generals that together they didn't prevent these atrocities, which began with the war. Bock, Manstein, Leib, Rundstedt, they share the most guilt, because surely only the upper echelons were in a position to defy the Supreme Commander.
That should have happened in 1933, 1934, when it all began.
When it all began, most of the officers had no inkling of the coming disaster. On the contrary, on Potsdam Day, the 9th Infantry Regiment paraded for Hitler and his henchmen. They hoped that Hitler, the strong man, would give the army more money and more influence. Even Henning von Tresco at first welcomed Hitler's takeover. Many senior officers like him were carried away with enthusiasm for a new beginning. Only later do they realize that Hitler is capable of anything. The prisoners in Trent Park speak quite openly about this. The British Secret Service transcribe every single conversation. It's a colossal task, for in their enforced idleness, the prisoners talk all the time. Not knowing they're being recorded, they admit to their initial enthusiasm for Hitler.
How healthy National Socialism was in the beginning. We worked like pack horses for the Nazis.
A pity. Those boys had to commit such atrocities.
At the beginning, I always used to say, oh, it won't be that bad. You can't make an omelet without breaking eggs. I used to think they were just minor flaws.
The oath to the Führer was another flaw. Since 1934, soldiers of the Wehrmacht had to pledge their allegiance direct to Hitler. It was both subservient and unconstitutional. Yet the Wehrmacht's leaders had suggested it themselves. The oath had far-reaching consequences. It made it difficult for most soldiers to question Hitler's orders. The captured generals also discussed the importance of the oath to Hitler.
Do you still feel bound by the oath of allegiance?
Yes. Well, the oath of allegiance applies as long as the Führer lives.
Do you consider the Führer mentally stable?
You cannot allow a subordinate to determine whether his superior is mentally intact or not.
Servility in the highest ranks of the army. The oath of allegiance meant something for a long time, even for members of the resistance.
Der Eid hatte eine ganz starke Bindung, denn das ist ja der Sinn des Eides gewesen. Und es hat unendlich viele gegeben, die sich bis zum letzten Tag an den Eid gebunden gefühlt haben. Auf der anderen Seite kann man den ja nur erwidern, ein Eid ist eine Sache auf Gegenseitigkeit. Und Hitler hat durch seine Untaten sein Eid wiederholt gebrochen.
Walter von Stülpnagel took part in the war against the Soviet Union as a young lieutenant. His father, General Karl Heinrich von Stülpnagel, has opposed Hitler's warmongering since the Sudeten crisis of 1938, even if he still uses the Hitler salute. For him, Hitler is a gambler, leading Germany to disaster. In the summer of 1941, General von Stülpnagel faces a decision. He must show his true colors. Is he just furious about Hitler's military ignorance? Or is he appalled by the war crimes? Stülpnagel is commander of the 17th Army, which is invading Galicia. The Jews, above all, are the victims of the Wehrmacht's occupation. Behind the front lines, the special task forces of the SS engage in genocide. Historian Christian Streit has documented how Stülpnagel's 17th Army Command cooperated closely with the death squads. Stülpnagel issued orders that fanned anti-Semitic feelings.
Zunächst ging es darum, dass Stülpnagel Befehle bekräftigte, die bereits gegeben waren, dass also Partisanen, die festgenommen wurden, sofort zu erschießen seien, dass man Sabotageakte oder auch nur passiven Widerstand auch dadurch niederschlagen solle, dass man sogenannte kollektive Gewaltmaßnahmen befahl. Bezeichnet es nun, dass Stülpnagel diesen Befehl zuspitzte auf die jüdische Bevölkerung. Er befahl, wenn man solche Vergeltungsaktionen startete, dass man nun in erster Linie Kommunisten und Juden dafür heraussuchte. Und er sagte, besonders die jüdischen Komsomolzen, also die Vertreter, die Angehörigen der Jugendorganisation der KPDSU, seien nun als Antreiber von Partisanenkrieg anzusehen und sollten deswegen ausgesucht werden.
Jewish Bolshevism, a common enemy that unites the Wehrmacht and Nazi fanatics. Stülpnagel gives the SS considerably more freedom of action than they should have had, according to the original agreements. Stülpnagel's orders step up the persecutions. He asks the SS to conduct reprisals against the Jews and demands an intensified war against international Jewry. The reprisals continue to increase in scale. Random sweeps and executions escalate into systematic genocide. But at the beginning of October 1941, Stülpnagel takes sick leave. He considers Hitler's assessments of the military situation to be completely unrealistic. He sees his soldiers being sent to their deaths without reason. Stülpnagel is replaced as the commander of the 17th Army. There is no written explanation for his decision.
Mein Vater kam ja mit der ganzen Kriegführung nicht zurecht und hat sich ja deshalb von seinem Posten entbinden lassen. Aus zwei Gründen, aus militärstrategischen Gründen und aus politischen Gründen.
Was General von Stülpnagel's conscience troubling him, or was it just a difference of military opinion?
Er hielt die Behandlung der ukrainischen Bevölkerung für absolut verfehlt. Die ukrainische Bevölkerung begrüßte die deutschen Truppen als Befreier und musste feststellen, dass sie von Hitler genauso als Untermenschen behandelt wurden wie auch die Russen. Und da hat er gesagt, da mache ich nicht mit.
Russians and Ukrainians are regarded as subhuman, and especially Jews. Karl-Heinz von Stülpnagel, the general who only a few weeks earlier had stepped up the persecution of the Jews, would soon join the ranks of the resistance. More than a million Jewish people are murdered in the Soviet Union, mainly by Himmler's SS. Colonel Henning von Treskow is now operations officer in Army Group Center. He's responsible for over a million soldiers. His strategic planning is meant to contribute to a rapid victory over the Soviet Union.